professors did. But you will be in charge of your own learning, and it's a responsibility you must not take lightly. This is my first and perhaps most important piece of advice. You know a great deal, but there's far more that you don't know. So stay humble, be curious, read voraciously, volunteer for the toughest assignments, and be ready and willing to learn as you go. And the higher you ascend, the more weight your decisions carry, and the more you have to learn. I'll be honest with you, I got to be CEO, and more importantly, I've stayed a CEO because I've remained a lifelong student. The truth is, we live in a world of disengage. The best form of education cannot provide you with a lifetime's worth of knowledge. You must continue learning as you go, and that will determine where you go. You know, there's a great line by the Spanish poet Antonio Machado that says it best. And he says, "Wanderer, there is no road. The road is made by walking. There is no road. The road is made by walking." To make a lasting impact, you must make your own road. To do that, you must never stop learning. Now, the next piece is the one I imagine you're all looking forward to, really looking forward to. And that's earning. You're entering a world where money looms large. With a little luck and a lot of hard work, you're going to make more than a comfortable amount of money as you leave IIMCalcutta. But you must never let your net worth define your self-worth. Never let your net worth define your self-worth. If you follow money in your career, you're likely to find it. But if you follow your passion, regardless of the money, you'll find something more. You will find fulfillment and inspiration that will prepare you further than the promise of that a big payday could ever do. And you'll likely find money too as you do that. So I urge you, first find your purpose. What do you want to create in the world that isn't already there? What product, technology or service would make life better for people, and how can you make it a reality? If you can solve a problem or improve a life, even in the smallest way, your career will be worth more than any currency. And just as important as what you choose to do is how you choose to do it. Businesses today are largely evaluated on their short-term performance, you know, on a quarter-to-quarter basis or on a year-over-year basis. But the most successful companies aren't those that shine brightly for a few quarters and then burn out. The most successful companies are the ones that create value for the long term, for employees, for shareholders, and for the greater community. Performing in the short term is important. You won't make a long-term growth if you don't perform in the short term. But a company that fails to invest in future innovations, that cuts corners on environmental sustainability, or shortchanges community stakeholders for the sake of a few extra points, is not going to make it for long. My proudest accomplishment at PepsiCo is the company-wide direction that I instituted, which is performance and purpose, which is our commitment to delivering strong financial results through sustainable business practices. And we're working every day against performance and purpose. It's a legacy that I hope to leave behind, and I urge you to start considering your legacy as you enter the business world. Few people in the world are remembered for earning a lot of money. So I challenge you to think bigger. Earn respect. Earn trust. Earn a reputation for being a fair and thoughtful leader. Earn a legacy you can be proud of. Because as I quote Henry Ford, a business that makes nothing but money is a poor business. To make a lasting impact, think big and build your life around long-term values, not just short-term value. Build your life around long-term values, not just short-term value. And that gets me to my final piece of advice, returning. Today you accomplished something wonderful, but it's important to remember that this is not your accomplishment alone. First, it belongs also to your parents and loved ones who have supported you, guided you, and most importantly, sacrificed for you. Your presence here today is proof enough that they've done the right job. So express your gratitude to them and please do it often. Call them, visit them regularly. Don't tell them you're too busy. You're not too busy. I run a Fortune 50 company and I call my mother 2 to 3 times a day. I call her 2 to 3 times a day. So all of you can make a time. Your parents and your loved ones are your biggest advocates and your best advisors. Don't ever take them for granted. The most important lessons don't always come from the people standing in front of you, it's the people sitting behind you. So do me a favor, graduates. Stand up, turn and face your loved ones, and give them a round of applause.
I
can't wait to see what you will do. Thank you.
Ms. Indra Nooyi, Chairman and Chief Executive Officer, Pepsico, and Chief Guest of Convocation, Mr. Agit Balakrishnan, Chairman Board of Governors, Professor Shriva Chattopadhyay, Director, Iim Calcutta, members of the Board of Governors, faculty and staff members of the Institute, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and my dear students. It is a great honor and privilege for me to propose the vote of thanks. I begin expressing my sincere gratitude to Ms. Indra Nooyi for kindly accepting the invitation of our director to be the chief guest of Convocation 2015, the Golden Jubilee Convocation function of the Institute, and deliver the Convocation address. It is needless to mention that Ms. Nooyi had to find out time from her extremely busy schedule for this function. I, on behalf of the entire IIM community, welcome you home, convey our deepest regards, and once again express our heartfelt gratitude to you for kindly giving your consent to be the chief guest of Convocation 2015 and delivering a wonderful Convocation address. May I now request Mr. Agit Balakrishnan, Chairman of our Board of Governors, to present a memento to our chief guest, Ms. Indra Nooyi, as a token of our appreciation and